हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज सुमित कर सेरा प्रेजेंटिंग अमेलगमेटेड मॉडल्स फॉर डिटेक्टिंग डुप्लीकेट बग रिपोर्ट्स।
The key highlights of this paper are: here are the amalgamated models for detecting duplicate bug reports using the textual and non-textual information of bug reports has been prepared and compared. The models which have been used for the amalgamation purpose are NGA, ESRBS, GLOBE, and NOSQL. And their amalgamation have been used to rank the bug reports based upon the similarity of them to each other. These models have been empirically evaluated by using three datasets, KDE, Eclipse, and Apache, which are from large open source software projects. And the metrics which have been used for the evaluation are mean average precision, mean reciprocal rank, and recall rate. From the empirical evaluation, it has been shown that the amalgamation of the models perform better than the individual approaches. Also, the combination of CFIDS versus VETCAN LDA. It outperforms the other amalgamated models for duplicate bug reasoning. So coming to the introduction part, when we talk about the software bug reports, they can be represented as defects or the errors. With this error description identified by the testers or it may be the users. These are generated due to the reporting of the same defect by many users. The same errors can be reported by different users. So that results in the duplicacy of the bug. And it is very important to detect the duplicate bug report because it helps in the reduce size effort. Further, these duplicates cost total effort in identification and handling of the bugs. So the developers, researchers, owners, and employees have always considered that identification of duplicate bug reports as a So the effort needed for identifying the duplicate bug report, it can be identified by the textual similarity between the two bugs as reported by different users. From figure one, we can see the different approaches which can be used as sparse and dense classification methods which can be used for the identification purposes. Here we can see we have sparse vector representation and the dense vector representation. In sparse vector representation, CFIDS and CTML come. Whereas in dense vector representation, we have GLOBE, VersiVec, SVD, and LDA. From these approaches, we have used CFIDS, GLOBE, VersiVec, and LDA. What we have done in this, the proposed model along with textual information also takes the non-textual information, which is product and the component information of the bug report. CFIDS, they identify the relationship between the documents. Whereas when we are talking about VersiVec and GLOBE, they use vectors which keep track of the context that is the co-occurring words. So in this paper, we have investigated and identified the following objectives: the empirical analysis of amalgamated models to rank duplicate bug reports, effectiveness of amalgamation of models has been checked. Statistical significance and effect size of proposed model has also been identified. When we are talking about this related work, CFIDS model has been proposed by modeling a bug report as a vector to compute the textual feature similarity. Similarly, an approach based upon n-gram has been applied already for the duplicate bug detection. But from the research, it has been identified that along with textual information, other additional features can also support the classification or the identification of duplicate bug reports in a better manner. So the first study which combined the textual features and non-textual features derived from duplicate reports was presented by Galbert and Demmer. The combination of LDA and n-gram algorithms has been said to be outperforming the state-of-the-art method as suggested by this group et al. No doubt there has been numerous research conducted and many models have been developed. And a recent trend has also been witnessed, which shows that the amalgamation of the model is in the key research now. But there exists no research which has till date combined the statistical, contextual, and the semantic models to identify the duplicate bug report. So that part has been covered in this particular paper. Next, coming to the data set and the pre-processing part. Here, the data set which has been used is a collection of bug reports that are publicly available for the research purposes and has been proposed by the SRIT et al. This repository consists of three defects rediscovery data sets which have been extracted from Bugzilla in .csv format. And the data set contains the information from three open source software projects, Apache, Eclipse, and KDE. The data set contains information about approximately 914,000 of the detectors over a period of 15 years. And it has also captured the interrelationship among the duplicate defects. Further, the data set contains two categories of features, textual and non-textual. The textual information is the description given by the user about the bug. And this particular table shows the description of the data set which has been used for the empirical evaluation. From here, we can see the number of reports respectively in Apache, Eclipse, and KDE, their opening date, their closing date, number of products, and number of products. Next, continuing with the pre-processing. Pre-processing and term filtering were used to prepare the corpus from the textual features. In further processing steps, pre-processing steps, the sentences, words, and the characters identified in pre-processing were converted into JSON, and the corpus was prepared. The corpus preparation included conversion into lowercase, word normalization, elimination of punctuation characters, and lemmatization. The methodology followed in this particular paper has been depicted in the figure. Here we can see the textual and the non-textual features both have been taken into picture. The textual features are fed to the models, that is CMIDA, Virtuex, Glove, and LD. All these models, they compute the similarity score and give to the next part. From the non-textual features, we compute a score for the non-textual features. So both are combined and a cumulative amalgamated score is evaluated, and it is validated by using evaluation metrics. And this score is actually used for ranking and recommendation of the top similar bugs. So in this map, we have combined the score and dense vector representation approaches to generate the amalgamated model for duplicate bug report detection. So the two or one models from LDA, TS, IDS, GLOVE, and Virtuex, which are the four models which have been used in this study, they are combined to create the amalgamated similarity score. The similarity score presents the duplicate bug report, the most similar bug report to bug solution. So further, as earlier discussed, it takes into consideration textual information, which is the description, and non-textual information, which is related to your production components, both into picture. Now, coming to the proposed amalgamated model, the proposed model considers textual and non-textual information as we have seen earlier, and further, it also has been identified that even the established similarity recommendation model, for example, next one, they do not provide the optimal and the accurate results, so the amalgamation of different models has been done to provide the better results. All the models, they give the similarity scores for K most similar bug reports as we have earlier seen in the video. So, since the weight of K from an individual method have own significance because each method works in its own way, so a heuristic ranking approach is used to combine and create a universal rank for all the results. The ranking approach assigns new weights to each element of the resultant similarity score vector from the individual approach and assign it equal to the inverse of its position, as we have shown in the equation, where Ri, we can say it is the rank or the weight assigned, it is equal to the inverse of the position in the map. Once all ranks are obtained for each bug report for each model selected, the amalgamated score is generated by the summation of the ranks generated as given in equation 2. So you can see from the equation, R1, R2, R3, R4 are the different ranks obtained from different models. If out of these four, if n, let's suppose three models have been used, and the value of R for the model which has not been used will be taken as 0. And here CC is the product and component score, and it works as the filter, taking into consideration the non-textual information as well. So, after all this ranking have been done, the four have been generated. Now we come to the evaluation metrics. The three evaluation metrics have been used here. Recall rate, first we talk about that. Recall rate is defined as given in the equation given here, and it has been early used by English researchers also. So it is given, recall rate is equal to 1. It's ground truth, and which we have generated the rank. The intersection of them is not equal to 0, it is 0 otherwise. This FQ here represents ground truth, and RQ represents a set of top recommendations. Next comes mean average precision. Mean average precision as a mean defines as mean of the average precision value as shown in the equation. So here, PQ is the precision, average of that is calculated, divided by Q, which is the number of queries in the test. Next, coming to the mean reciprocal rank, it is calculated from the reciprocal rank of the query, and the reciprocal rank is calculated as 1 upon index of Q. Next comes results and discussion. For the evaluation of the results, we have used the Google Colab machine with specifications as given, 24 GB RAM and 320 GB disk. There the algorithms have been implemented in Python 3.5, and it has used NLTK, sklearn, Jensen packages for model implementation. The default values of the parameter k has been taken as 1, 5, 10, 20, 30, and 50 to investigate the effectiveness of the proposed approach. And the other parameters of the algorithm have been fixed to the default value. For the empirical validation of the results, the developed models have been applied to open bug report data consisting of three data sets, which we have already discussed. The data sets were further divided into train and test data. The bug reports with ground source of duplicate results are taken as test data. So this in open source software data set, one of the columns contains the actual duplicate bug list. So this the bug report actually has duplicate bugs. That list is non-empty, otherwise it is empty. So this list worked as the ground source for validation of the evaluation metric. All the bug reports with duplicate bug lists are considered as test data sets. The number of bug reports for test data sets for Apache, Eclipse, and KDE are used at 2518, 34,316, and 30,377 respectively. From these, Apache data set is the smallest data set of the data set of three data sets, and it contains 44,049 bug reports. And these bug reports are generated for 35 products and 350 companies. For this, we will see from figure 3 and 4 that the amalgamation of models have shown the better results than the individual established approaches. This table represents the MAP values for the different models, the combination of different models. From the results, we can see that all the models do not provide the good results. So we can see it from the values of the MAP of individual and amalgamated models using all the data sets for Apache, Eclipse, and KDE. Coming further, the Eclipse data set contains 50,395 bug reports and 31,811 different IDs. Number of products are 232 and 1486 component bug reports. So because it is a large data set, the random sampling was done to select 10% of the data set. And the values of MRR and recall rate have been shown further in figure 5 and 6. Coming to next, KDE contains around 365,893 bug reports for 584 products, out of which 2054 has been used. Again, since it is a large data set, so we have used 10% of the data set by using random sampling. And the evaluation metrics have been shown in figures 7 and 8. Now, here we can see the recall rate of Apache data set for different models. All the values, all the models have been shown here. Similarly, this is MRR of Apache data set. Then comes the Eclipse data set, recall rate. Then comes mean reciprocal rank of the Eclipse data set. Then we come to the KDE, recall rate of KDE. Then comes the mean reciprocal rank of KDE. Now, from the values obtained in the table and from the figures, it has been shown that the amalgamated models have been superior as compared to the individual approaches. And it has also been revealed that the for two data sets Apache and KDE, the amalgamated model T of IDS plus Vertex plus LDE have produced the best results. Whereas for the Eclipse data set, the amalgamated model combination of T of IDS and LDA has generated better than T of IDS, Vertex and LDA amalgamation. So this it proposes that the combination of T of IDS, LDA and Vertex have performed better than the other combination of amalgamation of the model. So this is the result which has been derived from this particular experiment and the empirical evaluation. Further also it has been identified that Vertex and its combination produce better results as compared to the gloves. Now to find out the statistical significance and effect size, that is the third objective of this study, we have used this Wilcoxon fine rank statistical test to compute the p-value and also measure the slip delta measure. So by performing this Shapiro Wilk test, the normality of the results was identified. Since it turned out to be non-Gaussian, non-parametric test, Priam and Gauss correlation was applied to find out the relationship between the result of different approaches. You can see from the table, this is the interpretation of slip delta circle. This has been shown for one data set, that is the Apache data set. Similarly, we can see the values of p value of the Wilcoxon fine rank test, Eclipse delta, and Spearman correlation coefficient for Apache data set here. It shows that results have a positive correlation, whereas there is medium or large effect size, which means improvement is happening by the amalgamation of models. We can see from the value of the metrics and the values of Spearman plus delta and p value. Now, after this comes the next part, that is test validity of this particular research. So, internal validity we are talking about here. Here we have used the bug report system in the data set till the year 2017. The fact is that the size of textual information is small for each bug report, but the current work has applied the well established methods of natural language processing to prepare the corpus around the large data set. So that's why we believe that there will not be any significant threat to internal validity. Further, using the LDA, a bias may have been introduced due to the choice of hyperparameter values and the optimal number of topic solutions. However, to mitigate this, we have used the optimal number of topic solutions as following the heuristic approach as given by the two researchers earlier, which we have used. External validity is the generalization of results may be another limitation of this study. The similarity score was computed by following a number of steps, and each of these steps has a significant impact on the results. However, verification of results has been performed using open source data sets to achieve enough generalization. So the external validity has also been verified. Next comes the conclusion of the paper. So as we have discussed in this presentation, the main contribution of this paper is an attempt to amalgamate the established natural language models for duplicate bug recommendation using both textual information and non-textual information. The proposed amalgamating models combine the similarity scores from different models. The empirical evaluation has been performed on the different data sets, Apache, KDE, and Eclipse. From the validation, it is evident from the values of MAP that it has increased from 0.076 to 0.163, which is better as compared to the individual approaches. So this holds true for all the three data sets as shown in the experimental results. Similarly, the value of MRR for amalgamated model is also high relative the other individual models. So it can be concluded that the amalgamated approaches have achieved better performance than the individual approaches. And also we have identified that the combination of LDA, TF, IDS and that Vertex have worked in a better manner. The future scope of this paper is to develop a Python package that will allow the user to select the individual models and their amalgamation with the other models in the given data set. This would also allow the user to select the combination of textual and non-textual features from the data set for duplicate bug reports. So with this, I finished with the presentation of the paper, and so there are some of the references which have been used. Any queries from your side is welcome. Thank you for listening.